I'm here to present the updates on resettlement cluster. Firstly, would like to probably explain that there's about more than a million houses that were affected by Typhoon Yolanda, but the NHA is only in charge of providing permanent resettlement for those families that are living in unsafe areas. The other affected houses were taken care of by DSWD because they were in either safe, they were in safe areas, and they can be provided assistance through the emergency shelter assistance of DSWD. Let me just take you back on the housing need. This is for the permanent shelter assistance being undertaken by the resettlement cluster through the National Housing Authority. The housing need requires provision for permanent housing facilities for about 205,128 families. These are based on the provincial plan submitted to the OPAR, which was the basis of the Comprehensive Rehabilitation Recovery Plan that was approved by the President. If you'll see the table, this covers about 6 regions, 14 provinces, and 116 cities and municipalities. The biggest of the region is basically Region 6, which requires 117,203 housing, permanent housing facilities. Secretary Butch Abad mentioned earlier that there's already 93.7 billion of fund releases. Of that amount, the National Housing Authority was given about 26.9 billion to produce about 92,554 houses of the 205 housing requirement. You can see on the table the different dates of the releases and the number of housing units that can be produced by the amount provided. Just to complete the rehabilitation, as earlier mentioned by Secretary Butch, there's about 7 billion pesos that's coming from the dividends that will cover about 25,000 units. And in our 2016 budget, there's about 25.6 billion that will cover the balance of 87,405. Let me just discuss with you the status of the projects, the funded projects that are being implemented by the National Housing Authority. Of the 26.996 billion pesos, which is to produce 92,554 units, about 74,385 units are already started. And of the, 74,385 units have been bidded out or obligated. And of the said 74,385, we have 42,566 that are in various stages of construction, and 17,641 units already substantially completed. You will notice that there's a discrepancy between 92,000, the fund that was given to us, and the obligated amount. The 18,169 are now undergoing procurement. This will be obligated within the month or early next month. There's about 929 units that were already turned over to some residents of Tanawan and in Tacloban later. The targeted completion for these projects are as follows. For December 2015, we project that we will have a completion of 21,455. And in June, we will be able to complete about an additional 42,566, and in December, about additional 28,533. For those that are not yet covered and funded, not covered by any funding, and will be covered by the 2016 budget, we expect that the same be procured and be completed by 2017. On the next slide, we'll show you exactly where the projects are on a per province basis. So you can see we are already in 119 sites covering the following provinces: Province of Aklan, Antique, Capiz, Iloilo, Negros, Cebu, Leyte, Tacloban, Eastern Samar, Samar, Biliran, and Palawan. We have also, just to show you exactly where we are on the ground, we are furnishing you a copy of the different projects that we are undertaking in the different towns and provinces. So for Aklan, we have projects in Altabas and New Washington for a total of 893 houses. In Region 6, also in Antique, we are in Barbasa, Lawan, Patnongon, Tibiao, and Pandan for a total of 4,641 units. For the province of Capiz, we're already doing about 5,340 units in the towns of Ibisan, Panay, Panitan, President Rojas, and Rojas City. In Region 7 or in Negros Occidental, we're doing about 16,735 units. These are principally in the following towns: in Cadiz, in Escalante, in Sagay, in Silay, in EB Magalona, and in Victorias. In Region 7 or in Cebu, we are doing 1,951 in the towns of Bantayan, Daan Bantayan, Tabuelan, and Medellin. In Region 8 or in Leyte, we're doing about 7,624 in the towns of Babatnon, Carigara, MacArthur, Mayorga, Palo, Palompon, Pastrana, San Isidro, Tanawan, and Tolosa. Also in Region 8, we're doing projects in Tacloban City. We're actually doing 21 housing sites in Tacloban City, which is to produce about 14,433 units. Most of these housing units are already substantially completed, or about half is substantially completed. So because Tacloban, we gave priority to Tacloban City, that's why the construction in these areas are more advanced than the other areas. In Region 8, in Eastern Samar, we are doing 1,605 in the towns of Balangkayan, Kiwan, Hernani, and in Samar, we're doing 2,500 in the towns of Basay, Marabot, and in Biliran, we're doing 522. Lastly, in Palawan, we're doing 708 in the town of Colon. Okay, just to probably explain to you our processes, because I know that there's been complaints, we've been hearing a lot of complaints in the delay in the progress of the permanent resettlement. Just to explain to you the processes that we have to go through in order to deliver the permanent housing facilities. I would like to explain to you that, firstly, the difficulty that we have encountered really is, the first and foremost would be the finding land that are suitable for resettlement. For the 105-128 units that we have to put up in the six regions and the 116 cities and municipalities, we need to find about 1,367 hectares. This is basically what is required because the template that we're using is 150 units per hectare. The funding requirement is 59.9 billion. This is for settlement. The land that we should, the land that can be covered under a project should be titled land. This means that for those areas that do not have land that are titled, we have to defer some of these projects. These areas like Camotes Island and I think Dambantayan are areas that are not really, do not have cadastral survey and are some of them are also protected. So we still have to, although we met already with the DNR and we have agreed on a principle of use of prop to allow us to build resettlement sites in these areas, this is one of the major reasons why we are finding difficulty in implementing projects. The title should also be unencumbered, meaning it should be clean title. For titles that have adverse claim or annotation at the back, we cannot use them because simply because COA will not allow us to use these titles. No, and the land that we that we choose for suitable resettlement must be accessible to infrastructure such as water, power, and road network. Also, the land should be in safe areas and should not be susceptible to flooding, landslides, storm surges, tsunami, or earthquake fault. That is why we have to require and to have to get clearance from NGB and PhilBox. And additionally, the bidding procurement process, the shortest really that we can avail of is about 3 months. So it takes about 3 months before we can actually do the procurement after finding a suitable entitled land for the project. Additional requirements for permits and licenses from different government agencies must likewise be secured. If the property is agriculture, then we need to secure DAR conversion, which will require NEA clearances, etc. Another requirement that we need to do is to secure development permits from the local government units. Likewise, secure an ECC from DNR, and lastly, tax exemption from the project from the Bureau of Internal Revenue. Just to explain to you the process, the negotiation process, these are the timelines that we have to observe. We, for submission of proposal up to the contract perfection and notice to proceed, this normally takes about 3 months. Lastly, in the actual implementation of the project, let me just show you that for projects that are about for contracts for 300 units, the contract duration, meaning this is the actual construction of the houses, the contract period is about 195 days. For 600 units, it's about 285 days. And for projects for about 1,000 units, this normally takes about 420 days. This is the time required to actually complete the construction of houses. So that probably just to explain to you what the process that we're going through, that's why it's taking a little bit longer, or we're taking a little bit more time in the completion of the permanent housing facilities. The pictures of the different housing projects that we are undertaking, so you can appreciate the efforts of the government in providing permanent housing facilities. So this one is in Tacloban City. This is in Barangay Cabalawan. Families have already actually transferred in this site. This is also in Cabalawan. This one is also in, this is in Barangay Suhi in Tacloban City. This one is in New Kawayan, also in Tacloban City. This one is in Kawayanville, also in Tacloban City. Also in Tacloban. This one is a project of GMA Capuso, wherein we partnered with the local government, which is the Tacloban City, who provided us the land. NHA provided the site development, and the Capuso Foundation actually built the houses. So this is a partnership with the private sector. This is also in Tacloban. Again, in Barangay Suhi. These are different, actually, this we're showing you, but these are different housing sites, no? This is in Tanawan, Leyte. This is also in Tanawan, Leyte. This is in also in Tanawan, but it's in a different barangay. This is in Barangay Sakme. So in Antique, you can see that they're actually still undergoing construction. This is in Aklan. This is in Capiz. This is in Iloilo, in Negros Occidental, in Samar, in Eastern Samar. That will be all. Thank you very much.